Sir, can you hear me?
Sir, can you hear me now?
Yeah, now I'm able to hear. So
Sir,
I got your voice.
I don't know, sir. There was a mic issue, so I had to leave the meeting and then rejoin again.
Okay. Okay. Sure. So Javian, Sita, so only two members they joined here. Then what about the remaining others? I don't know. Anyway, as per your request, I posted some 30 questions in the group. Okay. And tomorrow morning 6 o'clock to evening 6 o'clock, I have given some time. So 1 hour duration, 30 questions are there. Okay. In that one, CET level questions also it is there. Okay. And some JE level questions are there. That means multi-type of questions are there. So hope so all the questions, it may be help you in examination, competitive examination. Okay. So better to attempt. 1 hour is the duration. So try to solve all the questions. Is any key mistakes and at all? It may be that. So because of most probably I checked last one question, I didn't check one here because I didn't get the time to clarify that one here. So for that one, I had given some answer here. So first you write, you check it out. How many are there? So hopes in between that one, whatever the correct key is deserved, once again, I'll forward that key also. You can cross-check with that one. Okay. 99% I placed as a correct key only. Only 1% I'm having doubt. Right, ma'am? Sweta?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So tomorrow morning onwards, tomorrow evening, you have some time. So better to take, make it as some space in your day schedule. In that time, you can take the test also. Okay. Right now. So what is the next chapter we are going to discuss means here? We are going to discuss about thermodynamics. Okay. Thermodynamics also actually we are having the weightage for any competitive examination. Okay. So what is meant by the thermodynamics and what it is going to be discussed means here? So thermo means actually thermodynamics is the Greek word one here. So thermo means heat. Dynamics means here flow. Okay, so dynamics means here flow. So heat flows and at all we are going to study dynamics. Dynamics. Thermo means here heat. Dynamics means here flow. Heat flow is we are going to study about here thermodynamics. Actually, thermodynamics is the branch of physical chemistry which deals with the study of the heat reaction, chemical reaction which releases the heat energy and at all. Okay, and thermodynamics, we are going to study under some of the macroscopic properties. Okay, under the thermodynamics, we are going to study about some of the macroscopic properties. Sir, what are the macroscopic properties? What is the macroscopic properties, ma? So basically, we can call it as a macroscopic properties. Which we can call as a macroscopic properties means the properties which we can see and measure is called as a macroscopic properties. Which we can call as a macroscopic properties means here the properties which we can see and measure, the properties are called as a macroscopic properties. Okay, sir, what are the examples of the macroscopic properties means here in this one? Pressure, temperature, volume, mass, all these are the examples of the macroscopic properties. Okay, what is the macroscopic properties means? The properties which we can see and measure is called as a macroscopic properties. Okay, so before going to the thermodynamics, first we have to know some of the terms, ma. Sir, what are the terms we have to know means here? First, we have to know what is mean by the system. What is mean by the system? So any one of you, what is mean by the system, ma? System is anything which is under the observation is called as a system. Okay, system is anything. So which is under the observation is called as a system. Okay, and we can call it as a universe. Sir, what is mean by the universe means here exclude, sorry, surroundings, surroundings, system, surroundings and universe, surroundings. The second term means here surroundings, ma'am, surroundings. So what is mean by the surroundings? What is mean by the surroundings means here, so excluding system, excluding system, remaining part is called as a surrounding. Okay, excluding system, the remaining part is called as a surrounding. Okay, and what is mean by the universe? What is meant by the universe? So what is mean by the universe means, universe is nothing but it is the system plus surroundings. System plus surrounding. The system plus surroundings is called as here universe. Okay, now we got the clarity. Sir, what is mean by the system? Means system is anything which is under observation. Now, hope so you are listening the class. While listening the class, you are observing some your monitor, or you are watching mobile, or you are watching desktop, or you are watching laptop here. So that time, laptop, desktop, and all comes as a system. Okay. Other than system, what are the remaining surroundings are there? That it becomes the other than system, what are the things are there? Okay. That we can consider as a surroundings. Okay. And system and surroundings are called as a universe. System and surroundings are called as here universe. And system and surroundings also separated by imaginary boundary or real boundary. Okay. System and surroundings are separated by some imaginary boundary or real boundary. Sir, what is the example of the imaginary boundary? What is the example of the imaginary boundary? Means we are studying about the osmosis process. What is meant by the osmosis process, actually? What is meant by the osmosis process, ma'am? Osmosis process is nothing but here, it is the process of the transfer of the solvent molecules from high concentration to low concentration through the semi-permeable membrane is called as a osmosis. So what is the osmosis, ma? Osmosis is nothing but here. It is the process of the solvent transfer of solvent molecule from high concentration to low concentration through the semi-permeable membrane is called as a osmosis. For that one, I will ask one question. Sir, what is the question means here? We are summer season, we are getting as a sweat. Summer season, we are getting as a sweat. Are you getting sweating or not?
Yes,
Okay,
sir.
so how are you getting as a sweat? My sweat is nothing but water molecule only, na. Sweat is nothing but here, it is water molecule. It is water molecules comes from our skin. Okay, comes from our skin. Okay, now solvent molecules are expel the water molecule. Its skin is, it releases some water molecules. Releasing of the water molecules is any possibility is that to see. How they are releasing and at all is any possibility is that to see, ma? No, sir. It is not possible to see also. Okay. So because our skin is made up of some cells are there here. Okay. Skin is made up of here some cells. We cannot find out the cells in our skin also. It is very small. It is very small. Okay. Animal cell, plant cell, pig bladder, parchment paper, cellophane. All these are the examples of semi-permeable membranes. All these are the examples of semi-permeable membrane. And one more question also. Actually, whenever you are giving the water to the plants, ma'am, where you're going to pour the water? And top of the water or bottom of the plant? Okay, top of the plant or bottom of the plant here? Where we are pouring water for the
Bottom of the
plants?
plant.
Bottom of the plant. Why you are placing the bottom of the plant only? Why you can't place as a top of the plant, ma?
So that the water can be absorbed by the roots.
How it is going to be absorbed? If roots are absorbing, means height, how it is going to be sent to the stems, okay, branches, leaves, flowers, and at all? Which process is happening in that one?
Osmosis.
Osmosis. Very good, ma. There also it takes as osmosis. So because of you are placing the water at bottom of the plant here. So from there, roots are absorbing the water and they send the water through the osmosis process. Okay. So in this one, cell wall, it is there in between the cell and soil. We have some cell wall, na? Okay. That cell wall is nothing but, is any possibility is that to see the cell wall here in plants,
no,
in animals?
Sir.
No, sir. Yeah. If it is, we cannot see, mean that we can call as an imaginary boundary. If two cells are separated by one wall, means that we can call as a imaginary boundary. And for example, one more take, real boundary. Sir, what is the best example for the real boundary means here? So already you know the classrooms. Okay. In your school or college, two classrooms are separated by one wall only now. Okay. So two classrooms are separated by one wall. If two classrooms are separated by one wall, means the wall is, it becomes as an imaginary boundary or real boundary?
A real boundary.
It is a real boundary. So wall and at all, it comes as under the real boundary. Cell wall and at all, it comes as a imaginary boundary. So system and surroundings are, can be separated by real boundary or imaginary boundary. Okay. Now, again, so based on here, system is classified into three types. Okay. System is classified into how many types? Ma? It is classified into three types. Okay. System is classified into three types. How many types of the system it is? That means here we have a three types of the system. How many types here? Three types of the system it is there. What are the three types of the system? Okay, so one is, we can call as an open system. One is, we can call as here open system. Second one is called as a closed system. Closed system. Okay, and third one is called as here, in here, open system, closed system, and adiabatic process. In adiabatic process. Adiabatic process. Adiabatic process. Okay. Now let's see. In this one, open system. Okay. In this one, open system. So what is meant by the open system? What we can call as an open system? Which we can call as an open system?
Sir, there's an exchange in both energy and matter.
Okay, very good, Mahia. Okay. If the heat energy and matter both are exchanging with the surroundings means. One second, ma. Isolated system. Sorry, open system, closed system, and isolated system. What is that one means here? Third one is here. Isolated system. Third one is here. Isolated system. Adiabatic process is different here. So, I got it out. Okay. So, what is the third system? It's isolated system. Third one is isolated system. Isolated system. Okay. Now, let's see, ma. So what is the best example for the open system means? We are taking some hot coffee. Okay. We are taking some hot coffee, ma, or milk also you can take in a container. Okay. So you can take as a hot coffee or milk or hot water. You can take the container. Okay. Now, if you keep the container away from some time. Okay. I think so everyone, you may have some coffee, tea. Okay, milk, right now. So, somewhat, so your mom has given some milk or tea or coffee here. Okay, so you are hurry to go to the school here. Okay, you are a little bit hurry. You forgot to drink that one. You forgot to drink that one. If you come by the evening, if you come by the evening and once you check it out means, is the quantity of the milk, it will be like that only, otherwise quantity of the milk is going to be decreases.
It decreases.
Why it is going to be decreases, ma? So because of milk is present in a liquid form. The liquid is, it undergoes to the evaporation. When it undergoes to the evaporation, means automatically quantity of the liquid is going to be decreases. Ma? That means matter is going to be exchanged with the surrounding. Then what about the heat energy? Temperature, if they kept in the morning, by evening, it becomes, evening also it becomes as a so hot. Huh? Evening also it is very hot. Hmm? Either it is hot or otherwise it is cold. Either it is hot or either it is cold, ma. It is cold, ma, here. So because of heat energy also exchange with the surrounding. So in open system, both the heat energy and matter are exchanges with the surrounding. That is only we can call as a open system. Okay. Now, in this one, if they placed as some lead, if they placed some lead, ma. If they place some lead means here, then what about the condition here? After some time, what happening? What happens, ma? What happens in this one? Only heat energy is going to be exchanged with the surroundings, or matter also is going to be exchanged with the surroundings by placing of the lead. So whenever you place the lead on the container, means only heat energy exchanges with the surroundings, but not the matter. Okay, in a closed system, only heat energy exchanges with the surroundings, but not the matter is called as a closed system and isolated system. So what is the example of the isolated system means here? Thermal flask. Thermal flask. In a thermal flask, if you take some hot drinks, ma, here, okay, some hot drinks, either tea or coffee or something means. In this one, what happened? Both the matter and okay, in thermal flask are in isolated system. Neither matter nor heat energy are exchanges with the surrounding. Either the statement is correct or wrong? Is the statement
sir, yes,
correct
sir,
or wrong?
It's correct.
Okay, in isolated system, what is the best example for the isolated system is thermal flask. Everyone, we knows about the thermal flask here. Okay, in winter season or sometime. So we used to carry that one. Okay, so nowadays in corona situation, in pandemic situation, everyone they used as a thermal flask. Why they used as a thermal flask and not all means here? Because of that time they told that to have a hot drinks. Even water also they told that to have some moderate temperature. So that's why everyone they used to carry the thermal flask in this pandemic condition. Okay, in that time what happened? So if you take the hot water means up to afternoon or somewhat also the temperature, it will be night like that only. There is no difference in the temperature. Okay, for a long time if you keep means here, there is no difference in the temperature. Okay, clear? So that's why here at the same time matter is going to be exchanged with the surroundings, ma. So neither matter nor heat energy are exchanged with the surrounding. That is only we can call as here isolated system. Clear? Okay. And
yes,
here
sir.
Again, macroscopic properties are classified into two types. Again, microscopic properties are classified into two types. Sir, what are the two types means here? So one is called as a intensive properties. One is called as a intensive properties. Okay. So another one is called as a extensive properties. Intensive properties and extensive properties. Sir, which we can call as a intensive properties means here, the properties which are independent on quantity of the substance present in a system is called as an intensive property. Sir, what are the examples of the intensive properties means here? Intensive properties are nothing but here. These, the properties which are independent on the quantity of the matter present in a system is called as a intensive properties. Sir, what are the examples of the intensive properties means here? First, we can take as a density, temperature. Okay, so temperature and pressure, temperature, pressure and concentration terms. What are the concentration terms we can take here? Concentration terms. Molarity, molality, mole fraction. So all these concentration terms are they considered under here intensive property and refractive index, specific heat. So all these are the examples of the intensive properties. Okay. And what are the extensive properties? Extensive properties. Sir, what are the examples of the extensive properties means here? The properties which depends upon the initial, the properties which depends upon the concentration of the matter present in the system here. Okay, the quantity of the matter present in a system is called as a extensive properties. So what is the extensive properties, ma? Extensive properties is nothing but the properties which are depends upon the quantity of the system is called as quantity of the matter present in a system is called as a extensive property. Sir, what are the examples of the extensive properties? Means mass, volume. Okay, so mass also it is a quantity based only. Volume also it is the quantity based only. Heat capacity, okay, and internal energy, enthalpy, gives free energy, entropy, gives free energy, So all these are the examples of the extensive properties. Okay, some of the extensive properties also we can convert it into the intensive properties. Sir, how we can convert the extensive properties into intensive properties means here, for example, density. How we can write as a density? So density is equal to mass by volume. In this one, mass and volume are both are extensive properties only, na? Mass and volume both are extensive properties or intensive properties?
Extensive.
Both are extensive properties only. So the ratio of the extensive properties means that we are going to be considered as an intensive property only, na? Okay, so some of the extensive properties are we can convert it into the intensive properties. Now we got the clarity, all of you. Sir, based on this one, how they're asking the questions in the MCET level or NEET level means here, sir, based on intensive property, extensive property, they're asking the questions. Which one means here? What are the examples of intensive properties and what are the examples of the extensive property? So you have to know all the examples. Clear? They're not asking any definition in the examination part. Based on the examples only, they're asking the question. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Next. So, what is the next means here? State function and state variable are there. Okay? So, state function and state variable. State function and state variable. What is meant by the state function? What is the state function? State function. So what is meant by the state function means here? State function is, it depends upon, initial state and final state of the system. And final state of the system. Final state of system. Okay. It is independent on path of the system. 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 Okay. So that is only we can call as a state function. Sir, what are the examples of the state function means here? Internal energy. Generally, internal energy can be represented with delta U or it represents with as a delta E also. Okay, capital E or capital U. Internal energy can be represented with here, capital E, sir, or capital U. Okay, and enthalpy. Enthalpy can be represented with capital H. Entropy can be represented with capital S and gives free energy can be represented with the capital G. All these are the examples of the state function. State function means it depends upon the initial state and final state of the system. It is independent on path of the system. Okay. And path functions also it is there. Sir, what are the examples of the path function? So path function means here, they'll show the direction, ma. Let us see which one is having the particular direction means here heat energy. Heat energy can be represented with Q. Work. Work, how are you going to represent? Work is represented as a W, na? So heat and work are the examples of the path function. So which are the examples of the path function means here? So heat and work are the examples of the path function. Sir, why you are taking as a heat is the path function means here, heat is travels in a particular direction. It won't be travel in all the directions here. Okay, so that means traveling of the heat is the path function. It's not the state function here. Because of heat is traveled from hotter body to colder body, but not colder body to hotter body. Got my point or not? Heat is travels from here, hot body to colder body only, but not to the colder body to hotter body. So that's why heat is the path function. Okay, and work is there. So work also it is the path function here. And state variables. Sir, what is meant by the state variables? Which we can call as a state variables? State variables. So which we can call as a state variables means here, the properties which gives exact information about the matter is called as a state variables. The properties which gives exact information about the matter is called as a state variables. Sir, what are the state variables means? State variables can be represented with capital letters. State variable can be represented with capital letter. Sir, what are the examples of the state variable means? Mass, volume, temperature, pressure, all these are the examples of state variable because of they give us exact information of the matter. Okay, next. Sir, process it is there actually. Process. So state process. What is mean by the process? What is mean by the state process? If the matter is, it converts from one state to another state. Okay, let us see simple example. I'll tell. Ice is solid form, liquid form, or gaseous form? Ice.
Solid.
Solid. Okay. So when you place the ice in the atmospheric air, slowly it is converted into
liquid.
Liquid. Okay. So in the conversion of the solid to liquid, okay, so something it is happened, some work is happened. Okay. So what it is happened is by increasing of the temperature, ice starts slowly melting. After melting, it is converted into the liquid form. Okay. The conversion of the solid into liquid form only we can call as we are giving some name. What is the name we are giving here? Fusion. We are giving as name is here fusion. Okay, that means conversion of the solid to liquid is called as here fusion, or that is also we can call as a melting also we are calling here. Okay, so that is we have some process. That means the state of the system is going to be changed from one state to another state. Okay, in the conversion only, that is only we can call as a process. Okay, so we have a different types of the thermodynamic process of them. We have different types of the thermodynamic process. Sir, what are the different types of the thermodynamic process? It is that means here, first one is called as a isothermal process. Isothermal process. So what is the isothermal process, ma? Any one of you? What is the isothermal process? Sir, isothermal process means the temperature is constant. Okay, at a constant temperature, if the graph is drawn between the pressure and volume, actually, so this derivation syndrome we can derive from the ideal gas equation. PV is equal to nRT. So we have ideal gases. Actually, states of matter is deleted for you. Okay, states of matter is deleted. I think so you may study it, na? You may study it or not, states of matter.
Yes,
Boyle's law, Charles' law, Avogadro's law, and at all. There we are getting as an isothermal process. What is the isothermal process means? At a constant temperature, if the graph is drawn between the pressure and volume, okay, what are the curves you are getting? That we can call as an isothermal process. That means in the changing of the system from one state to another state, temperature is we are taking as a constant. Okay, so when the system is changes from one phase to another phase, that time the temperature is become as a constant. Change in temperature, small change in temperature can be represented with dT. So dT is equal to zero. Okay, small change in temperature becomes as a zero. Okay, isothermal process and isobaric process. isobaric process. Sir, what is meant by the isobaric process? Isobaric process is nothing but change in pressure is equal to zero. Isochoric process is that. Isochoric process. Sir, what is meant by the isochoric process mean? Change in volume, it becomes as a zero. Change in volume. Okay, so baric process means change in pressure, it becomes as a zero. Isothermal means change in temperature, it becomes as a zero. Adiabatic process. Sir, what is mean by the adiabatic process means here? What is the best example means? In adiabatic process, neither matter nor heat energy are exchanges with the surrounding. What is the best example for the adiabatic process means? Thermal flask. Thermal flask are the best example of the adiabatic process. Okay. In adiabatic process, Q is equal to zero. In adiabatic process, Q is equal to zero. Got the point, all of you? Okay. And one more also it is there. Cyclic process also it is there. So what is meant by the cyclic process, ma'am? What is meant by the cyclic process? In cyclic process, once you check it out, ma'am. A is converted into the B. Again, B is converted into the C. C is converted into the D. Again, D is converted into the A. Okay. The whole process is converted into the cyclic process or in a acyclic process. First, A is converted into the B. B is converted into the C. C is converted into the D. D is converted into the A. Sir, what is the best example for the cyclic process? Which any live example it is there means here. Ghee. Everyone you are using as a ghee, na? Okay. So ghee actually, what is the
yes,
what is the physical state of the ghee, ma? Either it is solid or liquid. Ghee is solid form or liquid form?
It depends, no. Like if you keep it in a low temperature, then it becomes solid, and when you keep it in a high temperature, it becomes liquid.
Very good, Javian. Very good, sir, Javian. Okay, at room temperature, it is a solid form. So whenever you increase the temperature, means what happened? Slowly, it is converted into the liquid form. Okay. Again, what happened if the temperature is going to be decreases? Means what happened? Again, it is converted into the solid form only, na? So whole the thing is, it is a cyclic process only, na here. Okay. Now, in cyclic process, reactants are converted into the products. Again, products are converted into the reactant. Okay. So, that it happens in a cyclic manner. That's why we can call it as a cyclic process. Okay. In a cyclic process, change in heat energy. Okay. So, that means Q is equal to change in internal energy. So, which one, ma? So, U is equal to zero. Change in internal energy and change in enthalpy, it becomes as a zero. Okay, change in internal energy and change in enthalpy, it becomes as a zero for the cyclic process. Got the clarity? Okay, next. Here, reversible process. Reversible process. So, what is mean the reversible process here? So, reactants are converted into the products. Again, products are converted into the reactant. That is only we can call as a reversible process. So, what is meant the reversible process here? Reversible process is nothing but here. It is the process, the conversion of reactants into products. Products are converted into the reactants is called as a reversible process. And irreversible process also it is there. We have a irreversible process. So, what is meant by the irreversible process means in this one, reactants are converted into the products. But products cannot be converted into the reactants is called as a irreversible process. So, all these are the basic information of the thermodynamics. Okay, you want to study means about the thermodynamics, but you have to know about this concept. So based on that concept only, we are going to study about some major concept. In this chapter, what are the important means here? We are going to study about the zeroth law of thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics, okay, and internal energy, enthalpy, entropy, and Gibbs free energy we are going to be studying here. Okay, so in that only some important concepts are there that we are going to be discuss here. So first of all, we'll discuss about the zeroth law. First of all, we'll discuss about zeroth law here. Okay. So before going to the zeroth law, first we can study about internal energy. Because of, again, while writing the formula, formula. Sir, what is mean by the internal energy means here? I can't explain here. So better only, better first, I'm going to explain the internal energy. Sir, what is mean by the internal energy? So internal energy can be represented with capital U or capital D. Sir, how we can define as an internal energy means here? Internal energy is nothing but it is sum of energies. It is sum of energies. Internal energy is nothing but here. It is sum of the energies is called as a internal energy. Clear? Okay. Sir, what are the sum of the energies means here? If you take any system, we have a different types of the energies out there. Sir, what are the different types of the energies means here? One is we may have potential energy. Second one, we have a kinetic energy. Third one, we have a vibrational energy. Vibrational energy. And we have a rotational energy. Rotational energy. So all these energies are, we can call as a internal energy. Internal energy is nothing but here. Sum of the energies is called as a internal energy. Okay. So for ideal gas. The internal energy is equal to zero. For ideal gases here, internal energy becomes as a zero. Okay? Clear? And, sir, internal energy is the extensive property or intensive property? Internal energy. Niharika, is internal energy is extensive property or intensive property? Now only we had seen intensive properties, extensive properties. Sita?
Sir, intensive?
Ma, it is the extensive property. Clearly I wrote enthalpy, internal energy, entropy, gives free energy are extensive properties. Okay, all those are the extensive properties. Let us see. Sir, it is not possible to calculate the exact value of the internal energy. It is not possible to calculate exact value of the internal energy. Sir, why it is not possible to calculate means it is the extensive property. Extensive property. At the time, it is the state function. It is here. State function. What is mean by the state function? State function, no one told that. It depends upon the initial state and final state of the system. Okay, it is depends upon here, initial state and final state of the system. But it is independent on path of the system is called as a state function. Okay, so that's why how we can write as an intensive property, internal energy means here. So we can calculate the change in internal energy. We cannot count as an exact value of the internal energy. Sir, how we can calculate means delta U is equal to U2 minus U1. In this one, U1 is the initial internal energy and U2 is nothing but here, final internal energy. Clear? So by using this formula, we can calculate the change in internal energy. But it is not possible to calculate the exact value of the internal energy. So for this one, I can give one exam. Anyway, exams are coming. Okay. So which the example is which is related to us. Okay. And our parents also. Is it right? So parents, what they'll do? Ma? They'll pay the fees and they'll join in such a good institution. Okay. Is it right? So they'll join us in a such a good institution and they'll pay the fees and the term. But they don't want how you are going to be studying. But finally, what they want here, they want to see you as a good student and you have to get as a good marks in the examination. Okay, you want to crack the NEET, you want to crack the JEE. Is it right or not? Is it right or
yes,
not?
Sir.
Okay, either they'll ask how you are preparing, is any burdens are there, is any struggles are there, are you facing any difficulty? Okay, if you got less marks, means immediately they'll scold. Why you got less marks? Why you're not studying at all? Okay. So here also means internal energy means a state function means it depends upon the initial state. Whenever you are joining, they'll tell, let's see, you are joining and so institution. Compulsory, you have to crack the knee. But they won't tell how to study and not. Some people are there, some people they won't tell you. Okay. So Here, what is means a state function is depends upon the initial state, final state. They join finally, either you get as a result or not. If you won't get result, means at the result time, they'll score very well. If you got result, means they'll feel very happy and they'll feel very proud also. Is it right or not? So, in the cracking of the need to getting of the result, you are doing so much hard work. Okay, so behind that one, you are doing so much hard work. So, that we have to consider. Okay. Clear? Right, ma'am. And sir, what are the best examples which explains the internal energy means here? So one is heat energy. One is heat. Sir, heat energy can be represented with Q. So if you see, means we have two types of the chemical reactions. How many types of the chemical reactions we are having here? So we have two types of the chemical reaction. So what are the two types of the chemical reactions means here? One is exothermic reaction. One is exothermic reactions. So second one is called as a endothermic reactions. Second one is called as here endothermic reaction. Sir, what is mean by the exothermic reactions, which we can call as exothermic reaction? Which we can call as exothermic reaction, ma'am?
Those that release heat.
Very good, ma'am. In a chemical reaction, heat energy is going to be released as that we can call as a exothermic reaction. In an endothermic reaction, if the heat is absorbed, so absorbing of the heat energy in a chemical reaction is called as a endothermic reaction. Exothermic reactions can be represented with Q is equal to negative. Okay. So endothermic reaction Q is equal to positive. For endothermic reaction, Q is equal to positive. Okay, and what is another example which explains the internal energy means here? Work. What is mean by the work? Thermodynamics also is there in physics. In physics also you are having thermodynamics, sir. Having physics is thermodynamics is there in physics also. What is the definition for the work, ma? So everyone knows here. Force into displacement. Is it right? Force into displacement.
So these are all examples of internal energy, right?
Ishunma, we don't have any example of internal energy.
What's it?
We don't have, ma. Which you want any examples for the internal energy?
Yes, sir.
My internal energy means here, let us see. You are taking the gaseous molecules, okay, in a container. Actually, gaseous molecules are having, they are moving with high velocities in all the direction. Whenever they collide with one another, means they'll change the direction or not here? They'll change the direction, na? Whenever they collide means here. At the same time, here, molecules are having means here, they're having the rotational energy and vibrational energy also. Sir, vibrational energy and at all, you can observe in physics. Tuning fork. Have you seen or not tuning fork? Tuning fork, have you seen or not my library? Like lab, physics lab?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Samita, have you seen or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so once you beat that one means continuously it makes as a sound, na? Why it is making as a some sound? What is the reason it is there?
Actually,
which energy is there in that one?
Sound?
Sound energy, yeah.
I don't know.
My actually vibrational energy. Actually, so we used to play with a rubber band. So we'll keep in mouth and we used to play. So when you are tuning that one means you'll get some sound. Musical instrument like that here. You can play some rubber band inside and we can play some blade also. Play some metal inside of the mouth and if you so vibrate that one means you'll get some sound. Okay. So whenever once you touch means it is going to be vibrate continuously means that we can call as a vibrational energy. Rotational energy, whenever you're rotating, so that it contains as a some rotational energy. gaseous molecules are having vibrational energy, rotational energy, kinetic energy, and so potential energy also. Okay, so that's why we are comparing with the gaseous molecules. Got Samhita?
Yes, sir.
Got it or not?
Yes, okay. Sir.
Okay, now my here work, we are discussing about the work. So what is going to be the work? Work is equal to force into displacement. Okay, then how we can define as a force? Ma, force can be defined as a pressure applied on unit area. Na, here displacement we are representing with L. So area means how we can write, ma, area in area is nothing but L square, na, because of area is nothing but length into width. That means we can write as a L square into L. That means P L cube. In place of L cube, we can write as a P V. Na, L cube is nothing but volume, length, width, height. Length, width, height means that we can consider it as a volume. Okay. Now, so based on this one, based on the work, so work done in isothermal reversible expansion. Work done in isothermal reversible expansion. For that one, I'm going to be explained clearly. First, I'm taking as a one container. In that one, I had taken as a some gas. I had taken as a ideal gas in the container, and it is sealed with frictionless piston. It is sealed with here frictionless piston. Okay. The whatever the volume it is that I am considering it is as a V1 volume. Whatever the volume it is that I am going to be considered as a V1 volume. Okay. After some time, the volume is going to be increased. Okay. After volume is going to be increased. When the volume is increased, this means piston is moves little bit upside. So this is only we can call as a change in volume. Change in volume can be represented with delta V. Delta V is equal to V2 minus V1. Okay. Now, let us see why the piston is moves little bit upside. That is my question. Temperature is constant, ma. Temperature is constant. Okay. Temperature is constant. Then why the piston is moved little bit upside? But this one, can I give one example, all of you? Everyone? Ma?
Yes, sir.
Let us consider it as a one classroom. Okay. If you see in classroom means we have a windows, doors also it is there. Okay. While class is going on that time, windows. Okay. So windows and doors are completely open. Okay. Why they won't be close the windows, doors, ma, when the class is going on that? Why they won't close?
Because it will get too suffocating, no?
Very good. Why you are getting as a suffocation? That is my question.
Because like there's a huge number of crowd and there'll be less air for each and every one.
Yes, ma. Yes. And one more thing also happened. So what happened means here, everyone in respiration process, we are releasing as a carbon dioxide. So when the carbon dioxide content is going to be increases in the room means the temperature also is going to be increases. If the temperature is going to be increases, means automatically everyone they feel as a suffocation and they will get as a vomiting sensation. So to overcome that one, what they will do, immediately they'll open the windows. Immediately if you open the windows means here, okay, so windows and doors and at all means within a fraction of second, full air it becomes as a normal. Full air it becomes as a normal. And you'll get as a normal, you can observe the normal atmosphere temperature also. So why it is happening like that? What is the reason? Because of whenever you close the door, internal pressure it will be more. Internal pressure it will be more. By opening the doors and windows, immediately air is going to be comes outside. It travels from high constant high pressure to low pressure. So to decrease the low pressure, it comes outside fastly. So here also what happened? When the doors are closed here, it is completely sealed with the frictionless piston. Internally what happened here, slowly internal pressure is going to be increased. To decrease the internal pressure, it pulls little bit upside, ma. Okay, it puts the piston little bit upside. Okay, so that time what happened? Internal pressure is going to be decreased. Sir, when it is going to be piston is moves little bit upside means here, external pressure it will be less. P external it will be less. Okay, so according to that one, how we can write the so formula for the work done? That means work done by the system or work done on the system it is there. System only it has done the work now. Without our, is any, our effort is there in this one, in this reaction?
No, sir.
No, system only it pulls the piston upside. That means work done by the system. Okay, this we can call as here, work done by the system. Work done by the system. If the work done by the system means formula, how we can write means W is equal to minus P delta V. This we can call as a P external. Okay, so W is equal to minus P external delta V. Sir, P external is represented as a external pressure is less. External pressure is less than that of the internal pressure. That we are going to represent with the negative sign. Okay, right, ma? So what is another formula we are having means here? W is equal to minus 2.303 nRT log of V2 by V1. This is the one formula it is there to collect the work done by the system. Okay. W is equal to minus 2.303 nRT log of P1 by P2. This is the one more formula. Okay. So this one is work done. Work done on the system. That means when you are going to apply the pressure on the piston, the volume is going to be decreases. That it becomes as a V2. That time we can call it as a work done on the system. Work done on the system. Work done on the system. Sir, what is the formula we are using? Work done on the system means W is equal to P delta V. So based on this formula, we are having some of the questions in all competitive examination. Better to practice all these questions, my dear. Remaining part will continue in the next class. Okay. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
All welcome. And all of you attend the exam by tomorrow. Okay, all of you try the
exam.
Okay,
okay, sir.
Right, thank you.